Hey everyone, in today's video, I want to discuss on how you can correctly get the near critical activities for your schedule in Primavera P6. Last week, I made a video on how to get true critical path in P6, and many of you liked that video. So I was asked to make a similar video on how to get near critical activities in P6. Well, there are two ways. First one is where you ask the P6 to filter the near critical activities based on the total flow. When you install P6 for the first time, P6 by default identifies critical activities as the one with total float less than or equal to 0. To see what settings you have, click on this schedule icon and then options. I just recently installed this version and you can see I have it as total float less than or equal to 0. You can change this to a number which you want to be considered as critical for your project schedule. Now once you do that, close this dialog box and go to filter. Here you can define near critical activities by creating a filter like you see on my screen, where I have defined near critical activities as activities with total float between 1 and 15 days. Click on OK and click OK again. So what P6 is doing is filtering the activities with total float between 1 and 15. However, the problem with this first method is it defines activities as critical based on the total float, which would have been fine for simple projects with no actuals or constraints. But if you have constraints or project deadlines in your schedule, those things will alter the total float of your schedule, and you will not get correct critical or near critical activities using the method we just talked about. So the solution to this problem is to use float path. Let's clear the applied filter first, then click on schedule icon and then options. This time, instead of relying on our total float definition, choose the longest path option to define the critical activities. Several scheduling experts have said that this is the better of two options. Now go to the advanced tab and activate this option here and choose free float. Free float because Oracle has specifically mentioned on their website to choose this option when calculating critical activities based on the longest path option we just selected in our previous tab. Then select the final activity in your project schedule and finally enter the number of float paths you want to calculate. 5 is usually enough, so we'll leave it to that. Close this dialog box and click schedule. Now there are a few more steps before we can get our final output. First step is to add these two columns, float path and float path order. You can see that P6 has categorized activities under different float paths numbered 1 to 5. What this actually means is activities under float path 1 are most important or should be considered as critical to project's completion. And activities under float path 2 to 5 have the potential of becoming critical and are considered as near critical activities. Now to sort out near critical activities, click on filter and you can create a filter like you see on my screen with float path between 2 to 5. This should do the trick. Now one thing to note is after we apply this filter, we'll only get near critical activities. If you specifically want critical activities, you can create a filter with float path equal to 1, as all the critical activities fall under float path 1. Or you could click on the link above and watch the video where I talk about getting critical activities using float path method. Okay, so after we apply the filter, you can see all the near critical activities. The benefit of obtaining the near critical activities using float path method is it works even in complex schedule where you have several constraints or project deadline. It will not affect the results even when the constraints or project deadline alters the total float of schedule. I hope this video has been of help to you. Leave me a comment, let me know what you liked, what you didn't like about this video. Thanks and see you next week.